Hello and welcome back to Crouton Cracker Jacks. Today I'm going to show you how to make delicious old-fashioned malted waffles from scratch, including how to make them on a 108-year-old antique cast iron waffle maker. Now these waffles are absolutely delicious. They are different from Belgian waffles that you usually get or that you find nowadays. They are far superior to Belgian waffles in my opinion, and making them on an old-fashioned antique waffle iron makes them even better. So without further ado, let's get started. Now to start off, I'm going to make a batter, because of course, you're gonna need batter to make waffles. So in a batter bowl here, I'm going to add in 3/4 cup of whole milk. And you wanna make sure that your milk and all of your ingredients are kind of at room temperature here. I'm going to add in 1 large egg, as well as 2.5 tablespoons of butter that I have melted and let cool down a little bit. I'm just gonna add that into my batter bowl, and using a whisk, I'm gonna whisk this up. Just kind of break up the egg, get it incorporated into that milk. And once you get that mixed well, you want to add in 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract. And I'm going to start adding in my dry ingredients, which is 1 cup of all-purpose or plain flour, as well as 2 tablespoons of sugar, which is going to help it sweeten up the batter a little bit and help it brown. 2 teaspoons of baking powder, which is our leavening agent, as well as 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Now, magic ingredient, secret ingredient, is malted milk powder. This is what makes these malted, and this is what makes them old fashioned. I'm gonna add in 2 tablespoons of that. If you don't know what malted milk powder is, it is what makes a milkshake into a malt. So when you order a malt at a malt shop, this is what they add to it. It gives it that certain something something, makes these waffles out of this world delicious. So again, using your whisk, just want to whisk this together until there is no lumps remaining. Now, you don't want to go overboard with this. It doesn't take forever to whip this up. But once you get it mixed well, this is the consistency that you're looking for. If it is too thick for you, add a little bit more milk. But if you make this batter too thin, it's just going to run out the sides of your waffle maker. Now, speaking of waffle makers, I'm going to talk about mine here for a minute because I know I'm going to get lots of questions about this. The waffle maker that I am using is a Wagner 8-inch waffle iron. It is an antique. It is cast iron with wooden handles. It was patented February 22nd of 1910, which makes this about 108 years old or so. Now, I found this one in a junk shop for $15. It was completely rusted out. It looked like hell, but I went ahead and cleaned it up, reseasoned it, made it all nice and fancy like you see it here. And I've been using this exclusively for waffles for the last probably 4 or 5 years now since I've cleaned this up. It just makes superb waffles. Now, you do not need a cast iron waffle maker to make this recipe. You can make this recipe in an electric nonstick waffle maker. That's perfectly fine. But since we're doing old-fashioned waffles, I thought an old-fashioned waffle iron would be appropriate for this. But now that I got my batter made up, I need to preheat my waffle iron. And you need to preheat these cast iron waffle makers for a good 10 minutes before you use them. I've got my heat over medium high heat, and every minute or so, you just want to keep flipping over your waffle iron so it evenly heats on both sides. Now, how do you know that your waffle iron is hot enough? Just take some water, drip a couple droplets of water onto it, and the water droplets should sizzle and kind of disappear almost immediately. Make sure that both sides are evenly hot enough. Otherwise, if this is not preheated enough, your waffle batter will stick. And the last thing you want is stuck waffles in these old waffle machines or old waffle irons. Another thing that is going to help us prevent our waffles from sticking to the machine is buttering the waffle iron sufficiently. Don't be afraid of the butter here. I've got some softened butter here and using an old paintbrush. Obviously, this has not been used for paint. I only use it for butter. You want to butter your waffle iron both sides very well. I know it looks like a lot of butter, but again, the last thing you want is for these to stick. Then I'm going to take 1/2 cup measuring cup, and I'm going to put 1/2 cup of batter into the center of my waffle iron. I'm going to go ahead and close the lid. There's no need to spread the batter out as it cooks. It will kind of fill in the empty spaces. I'm going to set my timer for 3 minutes for this waffle iron. Now, if you're using an electric waffle maker to make these waffles, go ahead and follow the manufacturer instructions. Read those. Everything is done for you. However, these cast iron waffle irons kind of take a little technique to get it down perfect. And the best way I've found to do this is to cook the waffle on the first side for 1 minute, turn it over, flip your waffle iron, and cook it on the second side for 2 to 3 more minutes. And once those 2 minutes are up, go ahead and peek at your waffle and make sure that it is getting as done as you like it. If you want them a little bit darker, cook it for a little bit longer. But whatever side is the light side, that is the side that you need against the heat. It will continue cooking on the top side as well, just from the residual heat in that side of the iron. But once they are done to your likeness, go ahead and remove them off to a plate. Now you can see here as I am removing this one, it is not a firm, crispy waffle. That is a Belgian waffle. Belgian waffles are nice and crispy. Old-fashioned waffles are not. If you're looking for the really thin, light, airy, super crispy waffles, you need to look for a Belgian waffle recipe. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and rebutter my waffle iron and get another 1/2 cup of batter in there. But back to those Belgian waffles. If you're looking for a Belgian waffle recipe, you need to find a recipe that uses egg whites that are folded into the batter, or even a yeasted recipe. I'm gonna go ahead and cook my second waffle here. Now this batter will yield you enough batter to make 3 8-inch waffles on these old-fashioned machines. But there you go. That is how easy it is to make old-fashioned malted waffles, which in my opinion are the best waffles ever, on a 108-year-old antique cast iron waffle iron. I hope you guys enjoy. Definitely give this a try. And like I said, if you can find yourself one of these old-fashioned waffle irons, definitely get one. You will not be disappointed in them. With that said, I hope you guys enjoy. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. I would greatly appreciate it. If you decide to try this recipe, let me know how you like it down in the comments below. Subscribe for more deliciousness and to keep up to date on all my latest videos. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next time.